Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I am going to be doing a review of the Anastasia Beverly Hills Prism Palette. Now, I know I'm late to the game. This has been around for a long time and it has been reviewed by multiple people all over YouTube, but I thought I'd give it my 10 cents. 10 cents? 5 cents? 20 cents? Whatever. worth of my thoughts. So I'm going to go ahead and give you a review of this. I got this from Sephora Australia. This is originally $75 here in Australia, but I got it for 20% off because I'm a black member. When the US has their VIB sale, we also have something similar here in Australia, like a beauty insider appreciation event, something to that effect. So I got 20% off, so I got it off at $60, which roughly translates to $43. So not bad, considering that if I had bought it in the US, I would have had to ship it here in Australia, which would have cost me a lot more. Okay, so anyway, to get started, I just wanted to let you guys know what is on my lids right now. So all over it is Unity from the lid all the way to the brow bone. And then I've got Parallel as my crease color. I have Throne in the inner upper lid. I've got Osiris in the outer upper lid as well as the lower lash line. I've got Dimension in the inner lower lash line and a little bit of Lucid in the inner corners to highlight that. So I have been using this eyeshadow for the past 4 days, maybe, just using this by itself. I've swatched it, I've used it with different eyeshadow bases, and today I am actually not using an eyeshadow base because I'm really just using this for filming now. The best one still so far is when I use it with NARS eyeshadow base, and I'll show you my check-ins as I go through this review. The eyeshadows itself, I find, are very much like how other Anastasia Beverly Hills, pretty close to the modern Renaissance formula. Nothing like the subculture one. Now, the mattes are very pigmented, but also can be quite powdery. They're quite soft. I do find that Unity here, that looks very light in the pan, does not apply the same color on my lids. It actually comes off a little bit darker. Almost like if you look at that side by side with my skin color, it's very different. But when I apply it on my lids, it actually looks more like my skin color. So it sort of like oxidizes on my lids, which I'm not against that, just because it's not any darker than my my skin tone, but it's just, I thought it was just weird. The other mattes perform quite well. I have already used this. The only one, oh, actually I've also used Eden. I think the only one that I haven't used is Sphere, which is this sort of chartreuse yellow here. I haven't actually used that yet. I have swatched it and I found that it wasn't really the best yellow. My Inglot yellows are much better in terms of pigmentation. Anyway, I will go into the swatching. The shimmery shades, especially with the exception of Pyramid here, all the other shimmery shades feel like they are foiled eyeshadows, especially Sphinx, Eternal, and Throne are very, very much like foiled eyeshadows. Lucid and Pyramid are a little bit more flaky, I would say. Obsidian is not the best black I have ever tried. It doesn't really come off as black. It's not very pigmented. It's not very impactful. But it's good if you are looking to just darken or deepen your eyeshadow look. I would say. Now I'm gonna cut into the swatches for you guys, so you can see what it looks like as I swatch it on my skin tone. So here you've got Lucid, Eden, Dimension, and Parallel. And Dimension here is just a gorgeous sort of lilac silver shade that I I can't even explain it. It's beautiful. The next quad, you've got Unity, which you can barely see from my skin tone, Sphinx, Pyramid, and that gorgeous, beautiful throne. Lovely. Last six shades, you've got Osiris, Sphere, and Obsidian. That black there is not the best black I've seen, but yeah, whatever. Saturn, Eternal, and Lure. A few things to note on this palette. It comes in that velvety texture packaging that Anastasia is famous for, and I'm not really a big fan of that because, to be honest, it just gets so dirty. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but it already has a lot of white lint sticking to it, and I already know that this is gonna get really dirty really quickly. But other than that, packaging, very good, magnet. And I am actually pretty happy with the brush that this comes with. It's a dual-ended brush. One's a fluffy one and one's more of a lay-me-down kind of end. And it's very functional, actually. I don't believe I've tested the other brushes that I had from other Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes. But this one is really soft. It's not scratchy at all. It's, in fact, it's better than my Delium brushes. And this puts on the color very, very well as well. I used this actually today. And this side here I used for laying down Throne and Osiris, as well as putting Dimension underneath my lower lash line. So yeah, packaging wise, not the biggest fan, but let's talk about what's inside. I keep referring to my skin tone, and I have never actually mentioned what it is. I am an NC37 to an NC40, depending on the season, I guess. If it's summer, I'm usually an NC40. If it's the regular autumn, spring, or winter months, I am usually an NC37, sometimes an NC35, but nothing more than that. So more on the medium tan shade, okay? So this comes off in that color on my skin. Now, I'm going to show you my check-in. So like I said, I've used this eyeshadow with a NARS eyeshadow primer. I've also used it with the Milani eyeshadow primer, and I've used it with my Zoeva matte eyeshadow base as well. So you can see what it looks like and how long it stays on and how pigmented it is until the end of the day, depending on what primer you're using. Hey guys, so just a quick vloggy check-in. I used the Anastasia Prism palette today, and that's what's on my eyes. And I've got the NARS eyeshadow base underneath as my primer. So that's my trusted primer. Let's see how this eyeshadow is gonna wear. I also used the dual brush that came with it, and I was surprised by how good it actually performed. Like, it packed on pigment pretty well. So I'll come back to you guys after work. It is currently, as you can see from the clock behind, 7:33 in the morning. So when I come back home later, I'm gonna give you an update on how it's gone. I don't have any foundation on my face right now. I've only got the Hourglass ambient lighting powders and SPF underneath that. So just the eyes really are looking quite nice today. All right, so it is currently 3:40, so that's about 8 hours of wear already. I am really shiny, but look at my eyeshadow. It's, apart from the patchy spot here, it's looking pretty good. And it doesn't seem to be creasing, but that's more the primer than the eyeshadow. The pigmentation is really good, the blendability is really good. All right, so final check-in for the night before I wash up my face. It is currently 10:25 p.m. So I've actually had this for about 15 hours now, and as you can see, it's still almost as vibrant as when I put it this morning. However, you can see that they've collected at the creases of my lid since I've got hooded lids. You can tell at the inner corners that there's... Okay, so I forgot to check in this morning. It is 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I left the house at 7:30 with this makeup on. And as you can see, it's still on there. I use the Milani eyeshadow base. There's a little bit of creasing, which is, I mean, normal for me. But I am going to go out and cycle. It's been a rather warm day today here in Sydney, so yeah. I'm going to go ahead and cycle and come back to you later today once I'm ready to take off my makeup, just to see how well it's held up. But this is what it currently looks like now. Okay, so it is 9:25 in the evening, and that's about 14 hours since I've put on the eyeshadow. And as you can see, it's starting to collect in the creases of my lids, but the pigmentation is still there. All right, you guys, good morning. So this is day 3 of our testing, and I have got on the Zoeva matte eyeshadow base and the Prism palette on my lids. As you can see, I didn't put, or well, I actually used the same amount of eyeshadow that I used the last 2 days, but I don't think it's a fair, it's going to be a fair assessment today because, one, it's warmer today, it's going to go up to about 29 degrees, two, I've got my driving test this morning, so I'm probably going to sweat profusely and be extra nervous, and if all goes well, I will be at the zoo as well, roaming around. So this is probably gonna melt off sooner than the last 2 days. Because the last 2 days has been quite cool and relaxed. So anyways, that's what the eye look looks like right now. So hoping you can see that well enough. It is 10 minutes to 7 in the morning. And I will check back with you guys again at the end of the day after I come back from work, and then later before I remove my makeup, just so you can see how well this eyeshadow has performed under different types of bases. Alright. Hey guys, so I think this is going to be the only check-in that I'll be doing on this makeup look because I'm actually battling a migraine right now, and look at my hair. But yeah, this is the makeup look. I've had this for under 12 hours because it's only 6:30 and I put it on at about 7. And well, I can see that there's some transfer of the black that I've used as an eyeliner to like the lids, which is pretty normal for someone like me who's got hooded eyelids. I kind of expected that, but it's still pretty much there. This is over the Zoeva matte eyeshadow base, which I have discovered is not actually the best base. Granted that I had my driving test today, which I failed, and a zoo trip for the school, so it kind of like melted a little bit, but I guess it's not so bad if you're just doing like an 8-hour day. It's gonna work for you anyways. Plus, if you're not like out in the sun. Yeah, so far so good, I guess. It's held up well. Okay, so in terms of whether this is a good palette or not, I would say it's a good palette. I know that they have come out with Soft Glam and Nervina palette, and now they're coming out with a Solitary palette as well. But why did I choose to buy the Prism palette despite it being out for a long time already? I guess it's because, one, I like the idea that it's not based on whether it's cool toned or warm toned or a certain particular trend of color. Like, they had the burgundies and the reds with their Modern Renaissance. The Soft Glam is more on the nude side. Nervina's more on the purple kind of side. Yeah. I like this because it's not trendy. It's something that I can use on multiple looks. It's something that I can use without having to think about what I'm going to wear that day, or, you know. And if you look at this, in certain quads, you can actually create looks by themselves already. So I think that is a good thing as well, because, you know, you don't really have to think much about it. It probably doesn't look cohesive at first glance, but if you look at it in terms of how they are in their certain quads, you can definitely create looks with those four shades, however you want to combine them. All right, so very pleased with my purchase. I have since passed on my Modern Renaissance. I've passed on my Subculture. But this one I think I'm going to keep, because I really like the color story on this one. I like that it is, like I said, it's not following a specific trend of shades. And I think it's something that I can use years on, even though I'm supposed to dispose of it after it's expired. I really like it. Definitely keeping it. It's really pigmented, as you can see from my check-ins. It has lasted the whole of the day without any fading on the pigmentation. And but like I said also in those check-ins, I have super oily lids, so I guess it'll depend on what kind of lids you have, because in my case I have hooded lids that are very oily, so I really need to always have an eyeshadow primer underneath the eyeshadows, otherwise they're just gonna really disappear. So there you go. Like I said, let me know if you have the Prism palette. Have you enjoyed it, or did you declutter it? Did you give it away? Are you on the fence of buying it? Leave me a comment down below. Also, I do have the Revolution Makeup Carmi Kiss of Fire palette, as well as the Tammy Revolution. These are both collaborations with different influencers. Please let me know in the comment section down below which ones you want me to review first, and I'm gonna go ahead and do that. There was also a request for me to do more keto videos, so I'm probably gonna go ahead and film some of them as well. All right, I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.